Hello, I'm Tyler Vernon, founder of Biltmore Capital Advisors. Having worked with UPSers since the IPO, in almost every conversation that we have with our clients, we come to a discussion about protecting the value of UPS stock. This protection can be done in several ways, either through tax-managed diversification or other types of strategies. Today, I briefly want to discuss some of these other types of strategies that you may look to consider in your planning. Exchange fund is a vehicle whereby you can take large concentrated stock positions and exchange them for units of a diversified portfolio. Think about other executives in your shoes, from Microsoft to ExxonMobil and other Fortune 500 companies. All these executives put pieces of their shares into this portfolio and receive units of the diversified portfolio back. There's pluses and minuses about this, but at the end of the day, you're not taking an immediate capital gains tax and you're diversifying your portfolio. A collar is also another financial transaction that's put in place to hedge the value of your UPS stock. It's typically done for a specific period of time that could be a month, could be a couple years. When we implement this strategy, we typically put a floor on UPS stock that we don't want it to fall through, but we also put a cap on the upside of UPS stock. Now, when we look at this transaction, we fast forward to the expiration date, there's a few things that can happen. The stock can end up right between the floor and the cap, and in that case, the financial transaction goes away. We never needed it in the first place. But the stock could be way below the floor. In this example, if we put a floor of 90 and the stock was at 70, somebody would pay us $20 a share to make us whole. Alternatively, if we had a cap of 120 and the stock ended up at 125, we're either selling the stock at 120 or we're paying somebody $5 a share to exit that financial transaction. A prepaid forward sale is another type of hedge. In this example, we are receiving proceeds up front for the eventual sale of your stock, but that taxable transaction isn't happening for potentially a year or two down the road. So in this transaction, we might receive 80 to 90% of the value of our UPS stock today, which we can use to pay down debt, reinvest in a diversified portfolio. We'll continue to get the dividends from the UPS stock. And a year or two down the road, whenever we set up this transaction to expire, that will ultimately be the time that we sell the stock for tax reasons. If you're interested in learning more about some of these strategies to see if they'd be right for your particular situation, please feel free to reach out to schedule a complimentary conversation.